We're here in Meru National Park because we're launching the start of a very, very exciting project. I mean, I'm so excited that we're coming back to our sort of natural home, and we're going to be working on lions. So this is where George and Joy Adamson released Elsa, the lioness, and that's how the story, the book Born Free, and then the film Born Free came about.
My name's Virginia McKenna, and I'm a co-founder of the Born Free Foundation, which started 30 years ago in 1984 under the name of Zoocheck, because when we started, we were preoccupied with the situation of wild animals in captivity, zoos and circuses.
I was 5 years old when the family came to Kenya to make Born Free, and I have to say that I was sort of bitten by the Africa bug, and I think once you're infected, you can't ever get it completely out of your system.
In 1991, because our interests had developed and expanded to include the problems animals face in the wild, my husband Bill Travers suggested that we change the name to the Born Free Foundation.
The sun is going to burn through and take the cloud away.
We keep revisiting the places and communicating the story to people who come with us on safari, and this trip here is another opportunity really to go back in time and relive the beginnings of everything.
We are happy that our friend, the Born Free Foundation, under the leadership of Virginia and Will, have really shown much interest to be able to carry forward the legendary or the fame that Adamson had initiated from those early years that he started managing the protected area.
Because there's a bit in the film.
The lion population has been declining. We have between 40 and 50 in Meru National Park at the moment, and we feel that it is important for us to look for ways of restoring that the population that was there years ago.
It's a young male, I think young, on his own, under the tree, and he's got his foot up, just relaxing.
Kenya and many parts of Africa are awash with illegal weapons because of all the wars and insurgencies that have taken place. They're very cheap, they're very easy to get hold of. That means that carrying out wildlife law enforcement has become dramatically more difficult and more dangerous and more sophisticated.
Out of the 50 rangers that we got, five of them are lady rangers.
We need to help the Kenya Wildlife Service fight back with technology. So here on this trip, we've been able to buy and deploy with the Kenya Wildlife Service all sorts of equipment supported by Land Rover. Land Rover is our number one corporate partner in this regard, and we are providing tents, GPS units, binoculars, cameras, cold weather clothing.
Land Rover, Born Free, Land Rover, and our main partner, KWS.
All sorts of things that will make their task not just better, but more efficient, more accurate. They have limited resources. They cannot be everywhere. So they need to know where are the hotspots and then drive their limited resources to those hotspots and deal with the issue.
Wow. Well, this is just one example of the hundreds, over 150 snares in 1 week they've recently removed from the park. And we're going to see something even more frightening and terrible than this in a minute or two.
So when the animal comes, it gets attacked on the neck. As you can see it here, the snare got attacked here. So I can see these people, they are so clever. They know that always animal comes to drink water here.
The greatest problem is not so much of the poaching. It is the loss of wildlife habitats, the degradation of wildlife habitats that are then creating more human-wildlife conflict that then partly also feeds into the poaching problem.
We've had cases whereby the snaring of lions have been happening not within the park but outside the community land, because as the small game population reduces inside the park, the lions and other species, carnivore species, have no choice but to move out to the community land, to move out to where livestock also move along with people. In the process, they do a lot of predation because the food chain is already broken.
We have to stop it, because if we don't stop it, the animals will go, and then the whole balance of nature will be distorted. Balance is absolutely essential in life, and nature does it really well by itself. And we come along and we turn it upside down. It's topsy-turvy and it's chaos.
For the international community, we require support at two levels. One, to visit this country, see its beauty, and in the process contribute towards conservation efforts. And two, to stop consuming wildlife products, because that is what has put us under incredible pressure.
Tourism, and by that I mean everything from mass packet tourism right through to luxury end tourism, has a fantastically important role to play in conservation. Kenya, for example, has 500,000 people employed in the tourism sector. Tourism brings in over $1 billion a year to the Kenyan economy. It's a very important part of Kenya's economic strategy.
The current generation is reviving that spirit of George and Joy Adamson. We are paying homage to the work that went on then, and that we then handing over the baton to the new generation, that we're not letting those who went ahead of us to have done their work in vain.
This is the heartland of Born Free. This is where George and Joy Adamson both raised and released Elsa, and where she's buried. And we want to, with KWS and with the support of Land Rover, actually make sure that this is a lion stronghold for future generations.
I feel enormously grateful that we're still here, 30 years on, and the challenges are possibly even greater now, but so is our determination, actually, not to give in.